Hello students, I am Sunny sir from Mahdi English School. I hope all of you are healthy, fit and fine, staying at home, not going out unnecessarily, taking care of yourselves by cleaning yourselves regularly, sanitizing yourself and your surroundings. Be neat and clean, that is the only way to be safe, as of the present time. Also, I hope that all of you are eating the food made at home. Do not go outside for eating anything. Please, please do this. So, this video is for class 3, subject English. And before we start our video, let us read one thought. The best preparation for tomorrow is doing your best today, written by Jackson Brown. So, what is the meaning of this thought? The meaning of this thought is tomorrow, if you want to achieve something, then the preparation will start today. If you start practicing today, if you practice hard, then tomorrow you will achieve something. But if you just be lazy, that today I will not do anything, I will start tomorrow or the day after, then you will never be able to achieve success. So the only way to achieve success tomorrow is to start the preparation today. Watch the videos regularly, start preparing today, so when your exam time comes, you will be thorough with everything. Do not waste your time in playing. Do play, but do study. And studying is not only watching the videos on the TV screen or mobile screen, but it is also regularly doing the homework which is sent in the group, asking the doubts. That is called studying. Means you have to understand the topic, understand the video. In today's video, we are going to cover these topics. First, we will review the contents which are learnt in the previous video. In the previous video, whatever we have done, we will just see it again, recap in short. Then we will discuss the question and answers based on the understanding of the lesson. The lesson which we have understood, chapter number 3, the apple dumpling, we will just see the question answers from that lesson. We will understand the lesson with the help of extra question answers. Then we will discuss the notes to be written in the fair book, like hard words, etc. The notes to be written in the fair book, we will discuss it later on. So first let us review the content and then we will discuss the question answers based on the lesson. So in the previous video, we had solved the textual exercise of the apple dumpling. Which was the textual exercise? Let us see. So we had solved the textual exercises based on the opposite words. Then we had solved grammar exercise based on pronoun. What is a pronoun? Pronoun is the word which is used instead of noun. I, we, you, he, she, it, they, all these are pronouns. Then we had seen example sentences for the pronouns. That pronoun is used instead of someone's name or anyone's name. Then we had solved one exercise based on pronoun. Ram and I left at 4 o'clock since we had to go for football practice. Then what had we done? The children walked fast so that Dash could reach the school on time. So they, Dash studied hard for his test. So he studied hard for his test or she studied hard for his test. The house is beautiful. It is painted blue. We returned is. Why? Because it is house. Dash went to the market to buy herself a bag. So, she went to market or he went to the market. But we have to write she because here it is given herself. So, her is given. So, we have to write she. Tomorrow, Dash can come with me to the market to choose your birthday present. So, tomorrow you can come to the market. Why you? Because here your is given. That's why we have to write you. This is what we had done in the previous lecture. Then also we had done the other exercise. That is tick the correct option based on the pronoun. Ram and Raj carried some snacks with them. The principal called us to a room. The students realized that they could do the project easily. Let us keep the secret between you and me. Dash lent Dash her textbook. So, she lent him her textbook. Dash can invite Dash for the party. We can invite him for the party. Thus, this also we had done in the previous lecture. Then what else we had done? We had learnt punctuation. Which are the punctuation we had learnt? Capital letters, full stop, comma. Like everywhere in the proper noun there should be capital letters, and full stop should be there at the end of the sentence. Comma should be there when there is more than one thing, like two or three: flour, butter, sugar, apple. Four things are there, so we put comma over here, and here we put full stop in the end. Then we had done one exercise based on the punctuation mark. This exercise we had done last. Now let us discuss question answers based on the lesson which we have understood. These are the extra question answers not to be written in the fair book. We just have to discuss. You have to understand. No need of writing these question answers. First one: what did the old woman want to eat? The old woman who lived in the cottage, what did she want to eat? She wanted to eat an apple dumpling. So let us write the answer. She, first alphabet capital, she wanted, WANTED, she wanted to eat an apple dumpling, DUMPLING. She wanted to eat an apple dumpling. The old woman wanted to eat an apple dumpling. Next one, number two: what did she have in her garden? What did she have in her garden? She had plums in her garden. So let us write, she had, what did she have? She had plums, PLUMS, plums in her garden. So let us place the answer, she had plums in her garden. Then number three: whom did she meet first when the old woman went out of the house? Whom did she meet first? She met a young lady. So let us write, she met a young, YOUNG, young lady in the yard. That lady was standing in the yard of her house. So she met the young lady. First she met the young lady. Then number four: what did she get in return for plums? So when the old woman gave basket of plums to the young lady, what did the young lady give the old woman? She gave, what did she give? She gave bag of feathers. She got a bag of feathers, FEATHERS. She got a bag of feathers in return. So that is our answer. She got a bag of feathers in return. Then our next question is, to whom did she give the bag of feathers and why? So to whom did the young, to whom did the old lady give the bag of feathers and why did she give? So she gave the bag of feathers to the couple. And why? Because they wanted to make a pillow. So she gave the bag, what do we write? She gave the bag to the couple, COUPLE, couple. So that is our first answer. And why did she give? Let us write that answer also. Why? Because they wanted to make pillow. Because they wanted to make pillow. So she gave bag of feathers to the couple. That is our answer. Next. What is the next question? What did the couple give her? So what did that couple give in return for the bag of feathers? The couple gave bunch of flowers like roses, lilacs, lilies. So that is called bunch of flowers. So they gave her a bunch, B-U-N-C-H, bunch of flowers. Let us write flowers, F-L-O-W-E-R-S. They gave her a bunch of flowers in return for the bag of feathers. Next question is, whom did she meet next? What did she exchange? So after meeting the couple, whom did she meet and what did she exchange with the couple? So after meeting the couple, she met a young lord. So our first answer, let us write, next, N-E-X-T, next she met a young lord, full stop. That is our first answer. Then what is written over here? What did she exchange? What did she give and what did she get in return? So she get, what did she get? She gets a chain and she gave bunch of flowers to the young lord. So let us write, She exchanged flowers for gold chain. She exchanged flowers for gold chain. Means she gave flowers, bunch of flowers, and in return she got gold chain. That is our answer. Then number 8. Whom did she meet after that? What did she give them? So after meeting the young lord, whom did the lady meet? We have to write that answer. Whom did she meet next? So we can say that she met the family which was poor. So she met a poor family. She met a poor family. FAMILY. She met a poor family. That is the first answer. Then what is asked? What did she give them? What did the lady give the poor family? She was very helpful, right? So what did the lady give? She gave them the gold chain as the gift. She gave the gold chain because they were poor. They did not have the food to eat. So the lady gave gold chain to the poor family so that they can have some bread, they can eat, so that they will not die of hunger. So our next question, number 9, is how did they thank her? Means how did the poor family say thank you to that lady? What did they give in return? How did they say thank you? Let us write the answer. They gave her a puppy. That is the young one of the dog. So they gave the lady a puppy in return. So that to say thank you to the lady. To say thank you, they gave her a puppy. Then next one. What did the old woman do with the puppy? So whom did the old woman give the puppy? She exchanged the puppy, right? So what did she do with the puppy? She gave it to an old man. That is our answer. She gave it to an old man. Why? Because old man wanted puppy as companion and this lady wanted some apples. So what did the old woman do with the puppy? She gave it to an old man. Next one. Whom did she meet at last? Whom did she meet in the end? At the end of the story, we see that the lady meets an old man. So she met an old man. In the end, she met an old man. So this is the last answer. Let us see all the answers once again. The first question was, what did the old woman want to eat? She wanted to eat an apple dumpling for dinner. That was her favorite meal. What did she have in her garden? What did the lady have in her garden? The old lady, she had plums in her garden. Round, red, beautiful plums, soft plums. Then question number 3, whom did she meet first? When the old lady started her journey from her house, whom did she meet first? She met a young lady in the yard. The young lady who was standing in the yard was met by the young lady. She met the young lady who was standing in the yard. What did she get in return for the plums? So the old lady gave the bag of feathers. The old lady got bag of feathers in return. Why did she get the bag of feathers? Because the old lady, she gave basket of plums to the young lady. And the young lady gave the bag of feathers in return to her. Then number 5. To whom did she give the bag of feathers and why? So the old lady exchanged the bag of feathers with whom and why? So she gave the bag of feathers to the couple, the man and women who were fighting for making pillow, that is couple. Because they wanted to make a pillow, they wanted to make soft cushion, a soft pillow for their grandfather. So she gave bag of feathers to them. What did the couple give her? So finally, in return, what did the couple give the lady? They gave her a bunch of flowers like roses, lilacs, lilies. Then next, number 7. What is number 7? Whom did she meet next? What did she exchange? So after meeting the couple, whom did she meet? Then as she was going down the road, she met a young lord. A young man was there, very sad. So she met the young lord. And what did she exchange with him? She exchanged flowers for gold chain. The bunch of flowers that lady gave to the young lord, and in return she got gold chain. Whom did she meet after that? What did she give them? So after meeting the young lord, whom did she meet? Down the road, she met a poor family. A lady was sitting with the children, poor family. And what did she give that? What did she give that family? She gave them the gold chain, which the young man, the young lord had given her. She gave that gold chain to the family so that they could eat. Then number 9 was, how did they thank her? How did the lady and the children, means the poor family, say thank you to the old lady? They gave her a puppy. By giving the puppy, they said thank you to the old woman. What did the old woman do with the puppy? So when the puppy was there in the basket, she was moving on. And what did finally she do with the puppy? She gave it to an old man, because the old man needed the companion, the friend, to stay in the cottage with him. Then finally, number 11, whom did she meet at last? In the end, at last, when the lesson gets over, we see that she got apples. So whom did she meet at last? She met an old man who was sitting alone on the porch of the house, and that old man gave the lady some apples, and finally she was able to cook apple dumpling. In the previous video, we had also seen the hard words. So let us just revise the hard words, then we'll see meanings. We had also revised the meanings. Dumpling, dumpling. Weakness, weakness. Plums, plums. Roundest, roundest, means round. It is about the plums, roundest. Farmyard, farmyard. Feathers, feathers. Wonder, fuel, wonderful. Straw, straw. Pillow, pillow. Soft, soft test. Then number 11, lilacs, lilax. Lilies, lilies. Bargain, bargain. Jewellr, jeweler. Shed, side. Crust, crust. Supper, supper. Porch, porch. Companion, companion. Barking, barking. Then we had also seen the meanings in the previous video. Let us quickly revise the meanings. Yelled, shouted. Yelled, shouted. Bargain, deal. Bargain, deal, means to exchange. Supper, dinner. Supper, dinner. The light meal which you have in the evening. The late evening you eat something, that is supper. Companion, partner. Companion, partner, your friend. Crumb, a tiny piece, a small piece. Crumb, a tiny piece. This is what we had covered in the previous lecture. Let us move ahead. So our next topic is multiple choice questions, means MCQs. You have to select from the options, and this is also to be written in the fair book. So let us discuss. The old woman had dash to make apple dumpling. So what did she have to make apple dumpling? What all things she had? Can you find out from these three options? So the old woman had flour, butter and sugar. She had enough sugar to cook 10 apple dumplings, but she did not have apples, she did not have lemon, anything, but she had flour, butter and sugar. Next, number 2, the young woman's family loved to eat dash. The young woman who was standing in the yard, the family of the young woman loved to eat plum jelly. So second one, B is the correct answer. They loved to eat plum jelly. Then number 3, the man and women were arguing about how to stuff a dash. So the man and women, that couple, they were arguing because they wanted to make what? What did they want to make? They wanted to make a soft pillow. So number 1, A is the correct answer. They wanted to stuff a pillow. They wanted to put something soft inside the pillow so that pillow can be soft. So they were fighting for pillow. Then number 4, next. The old woman got dash in return for flowers. So when she exchanged flowers with the young lord gave In return, he gave a gold chain. So that gold chain is the correct answer. Number B. In return for flowers, the lady, the old lady, got the gold chain by the young lord. Then number 5. The old woman gave the gold chain to the mother because dash. So why did the old woman give the gold chain to the mother? Mother means the family, the poor family, those who were there by the roadside. Why did the lady give the gold chain? Why? Because she had no money to buy food for her family. They were starving, they were hungry. So they needed some money. So the lady gave gold chain so that they can eat some food and they can survive. That's why the lady gave gold chain to the family. Now let us discuss our next topic. Give one word means you have to write one word for the sentence. You have to understand the sentence and then write one word for the whole sentence. This is to be written in the fair book. First one, a small fried ball of duff stuffed with filling. So that is called dumpling. The lesson's name, the apple dumpling. So what is the dumpling? It is a small ball. And what is inside it? The small ball of duff. All the ingredients are stuffed inside it. All the things are kept inside it, like sugar, flour, apple, etc. With all that things, you can make a dumpling and it is a sweet. So the small fried ball, you have to fry it and you have to fill all this thing inside it and it is called a dumpling. And in this lesson, we saw an apple dumpling. Next, an area covered by the roof in front of the house, that is porch. P-O-R-C-H, porch. So what is the porch? See, outside of the house, many people have the raised platform where you can sit, you can keep the chair and you can sit and you can see the road. So that area outside the house, just in your compound, that area is called the porch. And the old man was sitting on the porch of the house. And there is a roof above the porch, as you can see. As we have already seen in the lesson, there was a roof above the porch and the old man was sitting over there. Pale purple or white flowers, lilacs. I had also shown you the picture of lilacs. Lilacs is a type of flower. And what is the color? Pale purple. It can be of purple or it can be of white. So purple or white flowers, as shown in the lesson, that are lilacs. Who gave lilacs to the old lady? The couple. They gave lilacs, lilies and roses. So one of the flowers that is given in the lesson is lilacs. Then number 4. Breathe out slowly, making a noise, usually in sadness, that is sighed. So when you take deep breath and when you breathe out and you make noise from your mouth, that is because of sadness, you are very sad, you just breathe very loudly and you take your breath out. Breathe in, then when you breathe out, when you throw your breath out, you do it with sound because you are very sad. That is called sighed. That type of breathing is called sighed. Now let us see the spellings. D-U-M-P-L-I-N-G, dumpling. D-U-M-P-L-I-N-G, dumpling. P-O-R-C-H, porch. P-O-R-C-H, porch. L-I-L-A-C-S, lilacs. L-I-L-A-C-S, lilacs. S-I-G-H-E-D, side. S-I-G-H-E-D, side. So our next topic is fill in the blanks, FBs. First one, an old woman wanted to cook dash for dinner. What did she want to make for dinner at night? What was her favorite thing to eat? Dumpling. She wanted to eat an apple dumpling. So we can write dumpling over here. D-U-M-P-L-I-N-G, dumpling. The old woman wanted to cook dumpling for dinner. Then number 2. She had enough sugar, dash. She had enough sugar to cook 10 dumplings. So what did she have to cook 10 dumplings? What was enough in her house? Sugar. She had enough dash to cook 10 dumplings. So she had enough sugar. Sugar makes the food sweet. It can also be added in the tea and other things. So sugar was there in her house and sugar was more than enough. She could cook 10 apple dumplings. That much sugar she had in her house. She came to a dash and saw a young woman. She came to a farmyard and saw a young woman. So farmyard means the garden, the compound was there, and the young woman was standing in the farmyard. So where did she meet the young woman? In the farmyard. She came to a farmyard and saw a young woman. FARMYARD, farmyard. FARMYARD, farmyard. Then number 4, walking along the dash, the old woman passed a young lord. So where was the old woman walking? Which street, which highway was she walking? She was walking King's Highway. And while she was walking on the King's Highway, she met a young lord, a young man who was very sad. So where did they both meet? The old woman and the young lord, they both met at the King's Highway. Now students, be very careful. Here it is capital. As you can see, K is capital, H is also capital. Why have I made it capital? Can you tell me? Because it is a proper noun. When proper noun is there, any person's name, any place's name, it is called a proper noun. So with proper noun, we have to write capital alphabet. With your name also, we write capital because your name is a proper noun. Same way, this is also the name of a place. So K and H, capital. KINGS, Kings, Highway, HIGHWAY, Highway. And see here, apostrophe S is there, apostrophe. Don't forget to put apostrophe mark. Number 5, she put the dash chain into the mother's hand. So which chain was there and which chain did she give to mother, the family? Gold chain. There are many other chains like silver and platinum, but gold chain was given by the young lord. G-O-L-D, gold. G-O-L-D, gold. So she put the gold chain into the mother's hands. Let us quickly read all. Fill in the blanks. An old woman wanted to cook dumpling for dinner. She had enough sugar to cook 10 dumplings. She came to a farmyard and saw a young woman. Walking along the King's Highway, the old woman passed a young lord. She put the gold chain into the mother's hands. Now let us see the next topic. Make sentences. Means the words will be given to you and you have to make your own sentence with the help of that words. Let us see the textual sentences with the textual words. First one is bargain. Bargain means to exchange. Exchange with someone, like we learned in the lesson. The game of the barter, to exchange. The old woman had a good bargain. So the old woman had a good bargain. Why? Because she exchanged plums for feathers and feathers for flowers. Likewise, she exchanged many times. So that is called bargaining. You can also say, I bargained a pen for the pencil. Bargaining means to exchange. And bargaining also means to argue with someone that please reduce the amount of money. For example, you can ask the shopkeeper that if it is of 10 rupees, please can he give you for 8 rupees. That is called bargaining. Next, supper. She ate apple dumpling for supper. Supper means evening meal, the meal which you eat in the evening before night. That is late evening. You eat something like snacks, that is called supper. She ate apple dumpling for supper. Who ate apple dumpling for supper? The lady, the old woman. You can also say, I ate pulao for the supper. I ate biryani for supper. Any sentence you can make of your own. Then last one, that is porch. What is porch? The raised platform outside the house where the old man was sitting. Did you remember? The old man was sitting on the chair on the porch. That is porch, that area. An old woman sat on the porch of the house. So that is the sentence from the textbook. Where did the old woman sit? The old man. The old man was sitting on the porch of the house. You can say, my family sits on the porch and enjoys. Or you can say, my father was sitting on the porch and reading the newspaper. You can make any of the sentences. So I would like you to make the sentences with these three words. So this is all for today. We complete our today's lecture over here. What did we study today? We review the contents of the previous video. We discuss the question answers based on the understanding of the lesson. And we also discuss the notes like meanings, hard words, make sentences and other notes. So this is all for today. We'll come back with a new video. Till then, all of you take care, goodbye, and have a blessed day. Thank you.